This video is brought to you by CatBeast.com. Design your own custom snapbacks and hats.
Let's get right into the news!
Today we are doing something that I have never, ever done, but like I don't really feel like making 2K7. I don't know what kind of videos I feel like making today, so a news video is what you're getting. And of course today, finally, the reason we're doing this, because 2K went ahead, they dropped a blog on, and they dropped a trailer, but we're gonna look at the blog on my team in 2K18. And we are gonna do a deep dive, well not that deep, but we're gonna dive into the blog because let's face it, that trailer was just the cringiest thing ever. So without further ado, my team 2K18 blog, welcome to your tape. Just kidding, I never watched that show, I don't even know what that reference is, but yeah, I didn't want to just look at the trailer because, you know, I'm not trying to get no copyright strike up in here, like I'm not about that life. But obviously the big news is the draft. I'll touch on that a bit, but I found some things in this blog a little bit more interesting, so I'm gonna point those out to you guys. Now the first thing up, these card types looks like the same tiers, pink, diamond, amethyst as last year. I'm not a huge fan of the cards right now. They look more like trading cards, playing cards you got when you were kids, but hey, I'm sure they'll grow on all of us. And look at that J.R. Smith card. Oh, that's my boy J.R. I didn't even notice that until now. Now, my thing about the draft is 2K, I know they couldn't just copy and paste Madden's draft mode, and they want to be original, and I understand the need for that and why you would want to, but they just add weird nuances into it that I don't think are necessary. So first of all, it's 5-player squad, 5-on-5 games. So is there not going to be stamina in these games? The fact that it's just 5-on-5, no subs, no bench, leads me to think they're not going to be like real games. Like, I think all we wanted was to have 13 rounds, we draft our whole team, we go out and play games against other people who drafted their whole teams. Like, that's it. Simple as that. But 2K, it just seems like they overthought it a bit. And then, of course, they have to add in where it's like, if you get to the final round or whatever, you can use VC to save your teams. So by the time you get there, like, you're gonna be playing stacked teams that people have saved players with VC. Like, I don't know. I'm excited for draft mode because I think for YouTubers like myself, like, I can do a tallest players drafter, highest overall, and get a cool video out of it, but it just seems a little bit off to me. Let me know what you guys think. Am I being too critical? Next thing, Supermax. This just seems, I didn't read too much into this. It seems like a new, improved My Team Online. They're always tweaking that. I think they're hoping to get more longevity out of this Supermax mode. But again, you guys can fill me in on that. I don't really care too much about it. But here is where we get into the good stuff. Now, over the years, since I've become a YouTuber, focus more on making videos and playing the game, I've got away from grinding on my team, but I think this year, for those of you that wanna grind, wanna make MT, this is finally your year. Now, obviously, 30 games for each team, 900 challenges. Now, that seems like a lot, but look at it this way. If you can get 1,000 MT for each challenge, you do them all, you got 900,000 MT. That is, you know what, as much as it's going to be a struggle and people probably won't do it, the fact that you could earn like 900,000, a million MT from challenges, that's all we wanted, right? And I like that they're still including domination and all time. Yeah. So for all of you maniacs who dominate every NBA team, every historic team, so they have domination and historic like usual, but now they add in all-time domination. That's like, what, another 33 lineups. So it's like domination last year, but you can probably earn another 30, 40, 50,000 MT. Again, like, if you want to do this, you can earn the MT. I probably won't, but if you're grinding the game, it seems worth it this year. And going on from that, again, another thing I don't really do, but I know a lot of people do, and a lot of people who are into my team do, is sniping. And I'm pretty sure, now, hold on. As a disclaimer, I don't know exactly what I'm talking about. I think I do. I think I have an understanding. If I'm wrong about something, please don't roast me. Just tell me why I was wrong. But the auction house, they have made live refresh. If I'm not mistaken, for sniping, this should be amazing because you can just sit on a filter like Ruby Historics and you're refreshing literally every second or every minute or whatever. And every card that goes up there, you have a chance to snipe. It's not like waiting 15 minutes, you refresh, and then waiting another 15 minutes. Honestly, I think for sniping, this is amazing, but just for posting stuff, like if I want to sell something and I need like 5,000 MT quick, I can sell something and within like 2 minutes, it could be sold like that. Thank you, 2K. That is a huge addition for the auction house. Now, we all know some of the struggles 2K always has with servers.
Derp.
derpity derp derp derp. And actually, this other thing, this is why I made this video, because I saw these little tidbits in here that I don't think other people are touching on. Reserve bidding. I love that. So many times when I'm making a squad builder, I'll put a bid in on like a Diamond Allen Iverson, but then I'll go out for like 5 or 6 hours and I'll come back. Now reserve bidding, I can say I will spend up to 300,000 MT, and then it will spend up to, I love that idea, because you can see what cards are priced worth. You can say, you know what, I'll buy it for that much if it gets that high. If not, I'll buy it for less, but I'm not going to overpay. I think that is honestly one of the best additions in this whole blog. No doubt, reserve bidding is a W. So like I said, for people who want to grind, make MT, play the game a ton, you got solo challenges, you got a way better auction house, I think, you know what, 2K, good job. Two thumbs up. Other awesome stuff. This year you'll be able to replace badges to a card. Again, that's really cool too, because if you waste a badge, you can just replace it. I think they're like little tweaks like that. It's not just about the draft mode. Like, that's awesome. Finally, you put it in, but I enjoy the little tweaks that are trying to make the game better and little things that I think they listen. You know, how to make more MT? We'll put in more challenges. How to make the auction house better? Well, we'll make it live refresh. We'll do this. I think just little things like that show that 2K care, and honestly, that's good, because that original gameplay trailer they put out, I was like, bro, this is nothing new. It's gonna be the same game again, but this year, it seems my team, boom, you're improving. Now let's check out some comments where there's always lots of intelligent people. So really, 2K, nothing about Park, my mans, Alex, this is a my team blog. I'm sure, use your reasoning and deduction skills. There will probably be a Park blog out soon. But why are you coming at the my team blog? My team is the one mode I haven't bothered to play since it came into existence, lol. Well then why are you on the blog? I don't understand, man, just don't click on it. Sounds good, but somehow you'll ruin it. Server issue. I kind of said that. Yeah, people will find some sort of way to cheese. Sprint cheese. Overrated card. JR Smith 85. How? Alright. Alright. You don't call out JR Smith cards. You don't do it. You don't. With you, Vic S. Patel. You know. Oh, you're in trouble now, boy. I'm coming for you. But yeah, I just thought I'd share this video, some of my thoughts. People might not really watch this video on my channel because it's not a squad builder gameplay, but when I read the blog, I was like, yo, I gotta make a video. So if you enjoyed, give it a thumbs up, share it around to other people if you want. If you want my opinion on more things, let me know in the comment section. Discuss down there, but be nice as always. Don't forget to subscribe for more 2K18 news videos. It's your boy, Killer J-Star, signing off.